In India, we have 6 fundamental rights. Among these, one is freedom of speech and expression. But why can't a common man enjoy this freedom? Why? I'm sure you all must be aware of Republic TV anchor Arnab Goswami's case.
Request kar raha hu, mujhe please bail dijiye. Supreme Court or central government ko intervene karni chahiye.
Let us come to the day when Supreme Court was hearing his case. Let me tell you the circumstances now. Talking about the content of his channel, Justice Chandrachur said, "I don't even watch his channel, whatever be his ideology. If you don't like it, then don't watch it." It was simple and straight. Now, here is the case of an artist, Rachita Taneja. The charges relate to 2 tweets that Rachita made about the Supreme Court granting bail to Arnab Goswami in an abetment to suicide case. Who is Rachita Taneja? She is an Indian artist, cartoonist who is recognized as the creator of webcomic titled Sanitary Panels since 2014. According to Taneja, Sanitary Panels is a feminist webcomic that comments on culture, society and politics. The webcomic covers a diverse range of issues, whether it be mental health or social issues or humor. Using black and white stick figures that Taneja manually creates using a pen and a paper. So a comic artist, Rachita Taneja, yes, a comic artist, you heard it right. On November 12th, she tweeted a cartoon which depicted the BJP and the Supreme Court being biased towards Arnab Goswami by granting him interim bail. The cartoon read with a reporter in the middle saying, "Tu janta nahi mera baap kaun hai," means you don't know who my father is. To this, a law student Aditya Kashyap attached screenshots of multiple tweets and claimed that these posts scandalizes the Honorable Supreme Court. Hints and characteristics, motives behind judgments of court. He said, the line between humor and contempt of the court has also been violated. These posts not only erode the trust in the institution of justice by casting aspersions on the justice delivery mechanism, but also interferes with the administration of justice. The tweets and posts are based on distorted facts, inspired by malice and amount to committing criminal contempt. Aditya then sought permission from the Supreme Court to initiate contempt proceedings against Taneja. The Attorney General permitted him and said, "I'm satisfied that each of the tweets with cartoons attached is in contempt of the Supreme Court of India." The AG said that her tweets were audacious assault and insult to the institution. The action against Rachita comes day after the contempt proceedings were initiated against comedian Kunal Kamra. The case relates in a way that Kunal Kamra also tweeted something that criticized the Supreme Court of India over granting interim bail to Arnab Goswami. In his consent letter, the Attorney General said that Kamra's tweets were highly objectionable and it constitutes criminal contempt of court. So from this, it is crystal clear that freedom is not a gift for everyone. But the confusion is, why would one target a comic artist? Because it was just a comic, nothing serious. When on Arnab Goswami's serious shows, Justice Chandrachur can say, if you don't like it, then don't watch it, then why can't this rule be implemented on Rachita Taneja's comic post? Now, the eyes are on the Supreme Court of India. Will the court go against or will it favor one's fundamental right? That is right to freedom of speech and expression. Thank you. Keep watching our channel. Like, comment and subscribe.
आपका मुद्दा बनेगा देश का मुद्दा. Maltix app पर शेयर करिए अपनी बात हमारे साथ. हम उठाएंगे आपकी आवाज.